Hello and welcome to today's video. It's so awkward to wave at you with this giant box in my lap, but I have a ton of products that I wanted to go through. These are more beauty related. This is like a giant collective haul from, I think, some of the beauty items or makeup items that I purchased. I purchased back in like the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty that they had in the fall. So that would have been like, what, September? And so yeah, I have a lot to go over with you. A lot of this was either gifted or I purchased along the way this year, and I picked up when I went home for Christmas. And so yeah, I figured I would go through with you. I'm not including like clothing or anything like that. This is just more beauty related items. So here we go. I'm gonna start with the non-makeup items first. So the first thing I'll go through is like a little tester kind of thing. So solid deodorant in Sweden is harder to find, and when you do find it, it's really expensive. So we bought, when we went home for Christmas, Beau and I like loaded him up with, he goes through stick deodorant like ridiculously fast. So we loaded him up with like 20 deodorants and like floss and things like that. We made like a Walgreens purchase. And when you bought those kind of items, they gave you this little like box, this beauty box, I believe that's what they called it, and it came with some little products in it. So it came with a coconut shea butter and cocoa seed butter coconut water, like cleanses and purifies mask. So that's one there. The next one is an Aveeno Max Glow Peel Off Mask, and that's kind of cool. Never tried that. I'm not typically someone who buys a lot of sheet masks, so whenever I get them in like these kind of things or like little Ulta gift packs, I am glad to have them, but I don't really reach out and buy them. Another little mini guy here, we have a Burt's Bees Fluoride Mountain Mint. It's just a toothpaste, I guess. Never tried a Burt's Bees or a toothpaste, so that's kind of cool. Then we have a Shea Moisture Skin Rescue Cream Cleanser, so that's kind of cool. Actually, really am looking forward to that because I feel like a lot of times the winter months here can be so harsh on your skin, so maybe that can be really, really nice and moisturizing. And then I have a little mini sample of Number 7 Booster Serum, little sample guy, so that's kind of cool. I'm going to try that out. And then the last thing in this box that I think I took some things out and gave it to other people, so this wasn't exactly representative of what came in the box, but out of the things that I kept, this is a little shampoo and conditioner Nexus set, so that'll be kind of nice. I like to have those things for when I travel. It's just nice to throw in like a liquids bag, especially since when we travel here in Europe, I'm surprised, but we really do a good job of traveling with just carry-ons, and so yeah, those kind of little mini guys are really fun to have for traveling. All right, moving into other items that are sitting in my lap. This one is very funny, and I'm not able to try this out yet. So I saw on Amazon they had this like those like halo band hair extensions, and this was like $10 or so, and I went ahead and picked one up because I've like always wanted to try hair extensions, but I know I could never be good enough to like clip them in or anything, and this seems so easy to use that I figure at the very least it could be a funny video even if it's a horrible fail. So I did pick up some hair dye, that's another thing, somewhere or right here, that I ended up picking up some hair dye that I think will go with this. And so when my hair, I got my sister-in-law to cut my hair when I was home for Christmas, and it's a little bit, it looks more thick than it ever has before. She did such a good job. And so I think once it grows out in like another month or a month and a half, it should be like, it grows out kind of thin. And so I think then it will look like my hair blends into this better. But the last time I put this on, it was like too noticeable from like short to long. So I'm gonna wait a couple months and try this again, but I'll probably show you in a video whether or not it's good or not. It might be a horrible fail, but it looked like, for $10, it looked like a little fun experiment to just try out because I've never had long hair, and I am excited to try that out. And since I just mentioned my sister-in-law, I'll show a couple little things that she gifted myself and my husband. She gifted us like little smile kits. So Beau got one, I got one. As well as she gifted me the fragrance that went along with this too, the Winter Candy Apple fragrance, the lotion and the body wash. And I left the spray at home intentionally because I kept just enough fragrance mist here in what I consider probably able to use up over the next year. And then, so I didn't, if I brought that here, I knew that I would also be traveling with it back home in a year, 2.5 years when we move back home. So I just brought these, but I do intend to use these up this year. I love the scent of this, and she was very thoughtful. She remembered how much I liked it last year when she got me this scent. So I got another one this year. And I forgot to say it in the intro, but this is, hopefully people would know this about me by now, but this is no way like bragging or anything like that. I mostly am trying to do this just to also hold myself accountable, like by showing people what I have instead of hiding it. Then I'm more aware that I need to use things up versus going and buying things. So that's what you're seeing here mostly. So the next thing that I have to show you is a little OPI duo set, and this is the natural nail base coat and the top coat. I have both of these products individually that I purchased before, and I love them. I found this for like $8 at TJ Maxx, and so I bought backups of them because I really want to get in the habit of wearing nail polish a lot more this year. And so I am going to put the other two that I have that are already open in my year-long project pan this year, and I'm going to work to finish them off so that I can open these up. Another product that I got, this was a 21 Days of Beauty product. This was the Clinique Take the Day Off Balm, and this one was that one that they had on for half off. So I have not tried this out yet, but I have a cleansing balm that I'm currently almost done with, so I think what I'm going to do is finish that one and then I'll try this one, or either I think I have one more balm or like oil, like cleansing oil, that I might use before this one since this one is so new. But yeah, I'm excited to have another like makeup remover in my arsenal, so this one is one that I'm really excited to try out when the time comes. I have one big hair set. I am someone who knows nothing about hair care pretty much, so I saw this set on sale at TJ Maxx and I decided to try it out, mostly because it had this like this middle thing that is supposed to help protect and condition your hair like long term. So it has the therapy shampoo, the therapy conditioner, and the BioSilk therapy. It says it's a weightless leave-in replenishing and reconstructing treatment to help repair hair, which is something that I feel like I struggle with. Typically my hair is, I have I think a decent amount of hair, but it's really 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 thin and therefore breaks really easily. So I figured maybe trying something like this product, and it's gigantic, maybe something like this would be nice to try. So I just picked up this little set here. And the rest of the things in this little box before we get to the makeup is all skincare related. I picked up my favorite salicylic acid cleanser by CeraVe. I love this thing. I swear by this thing. This, when I use this regularly, it is like the thing that I think helps my skin the most and like not get breakouts. But when I don't use it, I notice a difference. So this is one that I have a current one that I'm using up, and I'm probably gonna finish it within the next couple months. So I am glad to have a backup. And then also I got a bunch of stuff from like my favorite, probably my favorite like skincare brand, like when it comes to moisturizers and that kind of stuff. It would be like Timeless. I've heard about this company through Hot and Flashy. When it comes to like skincare recommendations and stuff, I get most of my information from her. She does some research and she gives really great recommendations, and I trust her. And so I will try to link her information below because I just think she's fantastic. If you're someone like me who you want to make informed decisions, but you don't really have the time to be doing all that kind of research, Hot and Flashy is someone that is I really trust. And so I have used up this one before. This is the big 4 fluid ounce size of the coenzyme Q10. I don't want to open mine just yet, but it's a big bottle. And I just finished my other one, so this is my backup for it. And then I went ahead and picked up a couple other serums just because I love their serums. I have used this one in a small size before, and so I went ahead and picked up a larger version of the Matrixyl Synth 6, I think is what it's called. Anyways, it has a little hyaluronic acid in it. It's a nice little antioxidant. It's really good. I enjoy it. So yeah, that is one that I got there. And then the last like bigger size, these are technically what they call the refill sizes, the 4 fluid ounce. So the last one I have here is my vitamin B5, and it also has hyaluronic acid in it. I have not tried this one yet, so I am curious. They had a killer sale going on, that so I went ahead and bought the large size of this. I just kind of was like betting on the fact that you'll like it, you'll be fine. And if I don't like it, nah, I'll live. But I will use it all the way up. So we're gonna try that in the new year. And then 2 products from Timeless that I absolutely cannot live without. These are, one I'm gonna start with like pretty much this week, and then the other one I'm gonna try to put in the fridge and just see how long it will last without opening it. These are the vitamin C serums, and they did change the packaging on these, which I think is really cool. They used to be in like dropper style kind of things, and the new ones are like airless pumps. So I think that's pretty cool. Like, I think it's pretty smart to have it in an airless pump. So I will open my new one up this week, but I do store these in the fridge. So if you're ever like looking for a vitamin C serum, this is the one that I think is absolutely fantastic, and keep it in the fridge. Feels great. It also makes it last longer. This I highly recommend if you've ever been wondering about like a vitamin C serum to add to your routine. And then they threw in a little like hyaluronic acid, like pure sample. So I have one of those. A couple other things before we move into makeup that I don't have physically here in front of me, but I did write down in order to disclose them to you, and that I also will have to put in my inventory numbers. I have a picture of fragrances. I got two fragrances for Christmas from family members. So one of them I already mentioned, the candy apple one, and then I got a Victoria's Secret one, which smelled very good. And then I have two soaps that I wish I could have brought the soaps over here, but we were at max. We were at 50 pounds each bag when we came back over. So I didn't quite get to sneak them into our luggage, but I did hide them in our storage room. And when we move back home in a year or so, I will be glad to dig those out and use them finally. Okay, let's move into the makeup. This is probably what you're waiting for. I'm gonna start with the items that I don't physically have here with me, since they're probably least interesting. But I went highlighter crazy when I was home. I went to TJ Maxx way too, well, I didn't go that often, but I went two, maybe three times, and I found some killer items that I really like was excited to pick up. So even though I kind of went a little crazy, I used all the products when I was home, and I'm so excited to have these items. I wish I could have brought them over here, but I have a big goal of using things up this year, so I did not bring items back. So these are the ones that are at home in storage. I have two foundations. I have a Laura Mercier, like the Flawless Fusion foundation that I found in my shade, and I grabbed it. And then I had the ColourPop Tinted Moisturizer. This one was one that I intended to bring home, but you'll see later that I was gifted another CC cream and I couldn't justify bringing both of them home. I know I will only get use out of one of them while I'm here, so I went ahead and brought the one that was gifted to me. So those two are staying home, but they're nice and new, and I don't really worry about them going bad. And then I have two Laura Mercier highlights. One is in like that pink kind of weird, it's such a cool pan shape, and honestly, it's probably my least favorite one out of the ones I bought, but I still love it. Like, if that means anything to me, that it's really exciting. It's this really pink one, and it has a little bit of glitter in it, which I actually don't mind. And then the other one is the like the baked one in 01. It's like a cult classic here on YouTube. I've seen so many people talk about it. And I wore that one several times when I was home too, and it's gorgeous. To me, it has just a little bit more punch to it than like the Essence Give Me, the Essence one, that the really natural baked one, I can't think of the name right now. They're not really the same. They're not really color dupes. I think the Laura Mercier is pinker and the Essence one's a little bit more gold in undertone, or champagne in undertone. But the Laura Mercier one has just the slightest bit more sheen to it, which is like, it's just subtle enough, but also still exciting enough to make me really, really excited for it. So I have those two. I also managed to pick up the Becca Opryski palette. I was so excited when I found it. I believe I found it at Marshall's, and it was like in like the protective string packaging. And so nobody had messed with it. It was completely untouched and beautiful. I also, in the 21 Days of Beauty, ended up picking up the Ofra Pillow Talk highlighter. I wish I could have brought that one back here. I love the Ofra highlight formula. It's beautiful. I'm really excited to have that in my collection. And yeah, then I picked up two blushes. Then I picked up one more highlighting palette from Laura Geller. It was like has three little mini highlights in it. And I wore that a good bit when I was home too. Very pretty. I'm very excited. I love Laura Geller powder products, or like her bake formulas and stuff. So I'm really kind of sad to see that she's kind of disappearing right now, but I did pick up one other blush from Laura Geller. I tried to spot any and all blushes that I could get my hands on, but I was only able to find one, and that was in the shade Roseberry. And it's a really beautiful, kind of more cool tone, but still like mauve-y. I don't know, it's really beautiful. I love the Laura Geller blushes. They're my favorite formula. So those are all the items that are staying home that I ended up purchasing. I went a little crazy, but you'll see this next like year, until we move back home to Sweden, I'm doing a no buy. I will talk more about that in a future video, hopefully, but let's jump into the items that I purchased when I was home, but they actually came with me here to Sweden. The first one is a Mario Badescu skincare spray, and this one is brand new, but I did end up using it while I was home just a little bit, but I love these like for products for putting on skincare. So that's, I did pick up one of these for myself because I finished one just recently. Like in December, I finished my other large one. I also brought to Sweden with me 3 foundations, which is a bit overkill, I realized, but at the same time, I feel like justified somewhat. So the first one was this CC cream from Pharmacy. I don't know anything about this brand. I think it's a MLM, and I'm not crazy about MLMs, but my mother-in-law sweetly gifted this to me. She uses it and really likes it. And it's in the shade medium, which I think is definitely gonna be too dark for me, but I have that white LA Girl one, the mixing one. Let me see. But I do have this LA Girl mixer, and so I figure at the very least I can maybe mix these two and try them out. And I did want to bring one really light coverage foundation over, so I figured maybe this will be that combo. And then I also, because I'm almost done with my It Cosmetics CC cream, I thought I would finish it when I was home, but I didn't quite do it. So I have my backup. This is technically not the CC cream. This is the full coverage moisturizer, but I've heard that they're very similar. And this one I got on sale, and the other one I couldn't find on sale. So I went with the one that I could find on sale. But when I travel, I do not mess with anything that does not have 50 SPF in it. So to me, this is an absolutely non-negotiable. I will not ever have like this product or the CC cream in my collection. It will always be in my collection because when I'm travel, I'm just outdoors and I do not want to mess with my skin like that. So this is one that, although I know I won't finish before I move back home, I'm very glad to have a backup here. And the last one was this gigantic Bare Minerals powder. I was trying so hard to find the normal size one on sale at TJ Maxx, but I couldn't. And then I found this one, they had this size on sale on Ulta. And this one was just such a better deal than the like other size that I just went ahead and bought the big one, even though I know I won't finish this guy. So I fell in love with the matte version of this past year, and I want to try the original one too. And I really enjoy powder foundations for like those days that you really just need to get out of the house, just put a little concealer on and put some powder foundation on. And this was my shade, and it was like such a killer deal. And so yeah, I went ahead and purchased this guy here, and I'm kind of kicking myself because I know it's so large and in charge and I'm not going to get through it, but at the same time, it's a product that I see myself getting a lot of use out no matter what in this next year to year and a half. Okay, I have one more product that I forgot to talk about. This is a Flower Bomb little like sampler, or it's not a sample size, but it's like the mini size kind of thing. This was a gift from Beau for Christmas. We gave each other really small budgets, and he got me a book by Neil Gaiman, which I love Neil Gaiman, he's my favorite author. And then he gave me this too, because he's always heard me talk about Flower Bomb and I've always wanted to own it, but he could only get the little guy as part of his budget, which I thought was so thoughtful. So this is one that I'm going to savor and use up over this year. Okay, I have 2 cheek products, and then I have a bunch of eyeshadow stuff to talk to you about. But first up is this Butter Blush from Physicians Formula in the shade Natural Glow. I blame Rebecca Morgan for this one because, yeah, she talked about it, and the way she talked about it, it's that it doesn't really provide a ton of like pigment, which I was like, it doesn't sound like it sells itself when you talk about it that way, but it gives like this beautiful healthy sheen to my cheeks. And because I love those baked blushes from Laura Geller, and I'm trying to pan a lot of like matte blushes this year, I thought this was the perfect product. It sounded like it was perfect for me and my taste, that if I put it like my cheek product on, my matte ones that I'm trying to pan, and I want that life and I'm missing that Laura Geller formula, that this is a nice like topper one to put on. I've worn it one time. I tried it one time when I was home and I loved it. So I'm so excited to have this here, and I'm so excited to reach for this constantly this year. Another product that I definitely did not need to buy, but because I knew I was gonna do a no buy for the next like year and a half to 2 years, or what I'm gonna try to do one, I knew I had to cash in some Ulta points and like get them gone because they were gonna expire. So I ended up buying a couple of these items down here that you'll see. So this was one of them. This is the Guilty Pleasure Super Shock Cheek Highlighter. And I love these. This formula is my favorite formula of highlight ever. And so I was excited to like pick one of these up. It's a nice peachy color and I love peachy colors. So I'm excited to have this one. All right, now let's go into eyeshadow. I will start with the littlest ones and then go to the biggest ones. I picked up 2 Super Shock shadows. One is in the shade Moonwalk. It's gorgeous. Oh my goodness. It's this beautiful like green kind of thing, but it's not green. I don't know. It's a cool duochrome. It's kind of got this brown undertone, but when you layer it over, I wore it with like some warm like transition shades and put this over like a green shade, and it just made it pop so in such a cool way. So I really, really like this, and I'm really excited to have that in my collection. Another one that I bought for myself is Birthday Wish, and I think I might have swatched this once, but here is Birthday Wish up close. So hopefully you'll be able to see. It's like this very pretty ultra glitter topper shade, and I'm excited to have that in my collection too, right there. These ultra glitter top coats are my absolute favorite, like favorite things ever from ColourPop. I also picked up two little single shadows from Marc Jacobs when I found them at TJ Maxx. I have never tried anything from Marc Jacobs, so I was super excited to find these things. And they were actually colors that I really could see myself getting a lot of use out of. So I'll talk about this one first. This is the Omega eyeshadow, and it's a gel powder eyeshadow, so it's this. And this is in the shade Oh Mercy. And when I opened it up and I looked at it, I was like, that is such a unique shade. It's kind of got this very cool red undertone to it, but it's gorgeous. I wore it one time when I was home and I fell in love with it. It's so silky smooth, and so I'm so excited to have this like shade in my collection. If you've seen any of my other eyeshadow videos, you'll see that I have a really large preference for red shadows, and so this is such a cool red shadow that I'm so excited to have this. Another one was a Marc Jacobs sequin little like cream shadow, and this one is, I was shocked that I found this because it's gorgeous. This is in the shade Topaz Flash, and I wore it with the other like Marc Jacobs. You really don't need much. I just swirled my finger in there way too much, but this is such a beautiful shade. It's so glittery. I wore it also one time when I was home and I was in love. So let me swatch it next to the red one. But like, I threw this in my crease when I was home and I put that all over my lid, and it's gorgeous. Like, I thought it was beautiful. It's got this really cool red and gold glitter in it. It's so beautiful. I'm so excited to have both of those so much. All right, and moving into the eyeshadow palettes that I bought myself this year, I told myself I was only wanting to get like 2 to 3, but I ended up with 5, which all in all isn't bad considering the number of eyeshadow palettes that I bought in 2018 was way more than that. So I ended up picking 3 of the like little 9-pan palettes from Color Pop-Up. I've always, always, always had my eye on the pressed glitter in the shade Hungry Ghost, and when I saw that it was included in this palette here, I got this on sale on like their like 20 or 30% off or so. So the fact that this whole palette cost me like $9 or so, and I really was already interested enough to buy this shade for, I believe it retails for about $5. The fact that I got the rest of them for $4 more, I was so pumped about. And I am really excited to try this out. I like a good peachy shade, and so in the spring, I'm so excited to pull this out. The next one was another one that I have been lusting over since it came out, and this is the Uh-Huh Honey palette. Yellows are some of my favorite like colors to wear, and so this one I could not pass up. I am so pumped about every shade in here. I think this is a beautiful palette. I did wear this one time when I was home, and I loved it. And then the last little 9-pan palette that I got myself, I have to admit, I did not intend to buy this, but I was a little tipsy on like closer to Black Friday, and I was placing an order for, I gave my sister-in-law a bunch of like ColourPop makeup, and when I was placing that order, I was I call it champagne sipping and ColourPop clicking, and I ended up putting this one in there again for myself, even though I definitely didn't need it. So I think I freaked myself out. I sent my Morphe 3502 palette home because it's large and bulky, and I love red shades so much, and those two red shades in that palette are some of my favorite shades in my entire collection. And I was kind of like fretting. I was like, oh my god, like I'm not gonna have those red shades for a whole year. And so I was like, tipsy Delin logic was, let's buy this one. And I tried this one time, and I think that if I compare it to the Morphe 3502, I won't love it. But I need to let this palette stand on its own. So I haven't really given it a fair shot. I've only worn it one time, but I do want to play with this a lot more. At the end of the day, I believe I paid about $9 for it, so it's fine. But yeah, this one is another one that I ended up picking up for myself, although I definitely did not need it. And then I have two larger palettes here, and this one is a Jackie Ina ABH palette. Both of these are ABH palettes. This one I bought for myself in like September, October. I had a like $10 off 35 or something, and then like a coupon. And so I ended up picking up this palette here. And so this is what it looks like up close and personal. It is gorgeous. I have worn this palette like once or twice so far, and it's so beautiful. I'm so stinking excited to have this one in my collection. Plus, I've heard so many good like reviews and like people love this palette, so I'm so excited to have my hands on it finally. And then the last one I picked up was again, I used my Ulta points to get this one. This is the ABH Soft Glam. I was in store and I knew I had to use my points in store, and I did not want to like place an online order because I always end up buying more than I intend to. So I did end up, I couldn't pick like a color scheme that I was really excited about. I went ahead and picked based on formula. And since I love the ABH formula so much, I went ahead and picked this one up. I've heard a lot of people rave about this palette too. And initially I have to say like, I'm a little bit like, oh, I probably didn't need it. But at the same time, I know once I get into this, these are my bread and butter colors and I'm gonna love it. I just haven't had a chance to play with it yet. So I am excited to try this out this year. Okay, that is everything for this little collective haul. It's a lot of stuff, I know. But yeah, as I said before, hopefully I'll get a video up at some point. I gotta plan it a little bit more to kind of go over some of my no-buy stuff. But I definitely foresee myself being pretty successful in my no-buy this year, or this coming year, and probably part of the next year. I struggled even there at the end when I knew I had to cash out my Ulta points. I was like, I don't really want a lot of makeup. Like, there's not a lot out there that I really want that has caught my attention. And so, yeah, I'm really excited about the things that I do have. And I'm sitting here, I realize I'm sitting here waffling going, I definitely know I don't need a lot of things, but I really like what I got. And I think that I need to kind of be okay in the middle, knowing that like, I have a larger collection and it's okay. Like, I want a little bit of a little bit of selection, a little bit of variation, a little bit of variety. And then at the same time, I want to steadily use up items too. So I'm still trying to figure out where my happy medium is, but for now I think I'm okay. And yeah, these are just some things that I wanted to be like fully upfront and like disclose that I did buy these things or get these things and get as gifts for myself. And so now it's all out there in the open and we can all move on. But anyways, make sure you say hello in the comments and I will see you in the next one.